A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th December, on the front page you have four accused in Disha's murder killed near Hyderabad. So this is Disha murder case. The case of 27-year-old Hyderabad veterinary doctor who was gang raped and murdered. So the four accused in this case, the police took them to the scene of crime for reconstruction of the crime. And it is said they attacked the police and tried to escape and all four have been killed in this encounter. And this is Unnao rape victim dies in hospital. So this is 23-year-old rape victim from Unnao. Here the rape victim herself has died. She was attacked and she suffered 97% burns and now she is dead. This is the timeline of Unnao rape case. You can see it was in 2017, June 2017, when this girl, then 17-year-old, had alleged that she was raped by BJP MLA Kuldeep Singh Sengar, who is a four-time MLA from UP. And after that, you can see what has happened. So it was in April 2018, you can see that victim's father was beaten up by some persons allegedly at the behest of the MLA Sengar. He was arrested under the Arms Act and victim tried to immolate herself outside Chief Minister's residence, Yogi Adityanath's residence, alleging police inaction, after which the attack on her father came to light. And in April, a day later, the victim's father died in custody, allegedly after police torture following his arrest. And after that, it was Sengar who was arrested after the victim's father died in police custody. Then after he was arrested in December, it was an FIR which was lodged against the victim and her family for allegedly submitting forged proof of age to show her as minor at the time of rape. So this is December 2018, FIR against the victim. And then in July 2019, victim's uncle was convicted in 19-year-old case and sentenced to 10 years jail in a case filed by Sengar's brother. And then after that, you can see the father was tortured, her father died, her uncle was tortured and put in a case filed by Sengar. Then this is a few days later. You can see victim and her family wrote a letter to CJI also expressing fear over threat and danger to their lives from Sengar and his men. And in July, you can see a speeding truck rammed into their car, which the victim and her family and their lawyer were traveling in. Her two aunts were killed and the victim and the advocate were critically injured. Then again an FIR was filed against Sengar and nine accused in this road accident case. And then a day later, the victim's letter to CJI came to light. And this was the letter she had written on July 17, before the accident or the attempt to murder, you can say, was a staged accident. And then when the letter came to light on July 31, the next day, Supreme Court took cognizance of the letter and sought report from Secretary General on delay in placing it before the court. And Supreme Court has directed all five cases registered in connection with the incident from a court in UP to court in Delhi. But now what we hear is that the Unnao rape victim has died of she was burnt and you can see she was going to visit her lawyer. It is said early in the morning she was at the station, on her way to the station, railway station, and she was set ablaze. She suffered 97% burns and died. And in this case also, Disha murder case, where we see that in an encounter, the rape accused have died. NHRC has ordered investigation into the incident. It has into these deaths which have taken place. Then below you have no Indian study links pollution to mortality. So this is Union Health Ministry funded study which was published a year ago. It is said that pollution is linked to mortality, deaths of people. But now Union Minister of Environment Prakash Javadekar said in Lok Sabha that there is no such Indian study which shows direct correlation between pollution and mortality. So of course, pollution would result in lungs being affected and then it would be resulting in deaths. So here actually in 2018, in December, India State Level Disease Burden Initiative, which consists of at least 100 health professionals, reported that 1 in 8 deaths in India were attributed to air pollution. And average life expectancy in India would have been 1.7 years higher had the air pollution levels been less than the minimal levels, causing health loss. So these studies by this India State Level Disease Burden Initiative are funded by Union Health Ministry and they involve the PHFI2, Public Health Foundation of India, ICMR. So this is the case. The minister now says that there is no Indian study. And she says there's no direct link, direct correlation between pollution and mortality. On page 8, you have existing antivenom therapy for snake bite is inefficient. So this is Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru study, which says that treatment fails to work against poisons of species other than the big four. Below you have weight issue halted train 18 construction. So, train 18, which is indigenously constructed train, which is also called Vande Bharat Express. So, the production has been halted, production of its rakes at Integral Coach Factory in Chennai. So, it is said it is halted because the self-propelled train is heavier and consumes more power compared to Shatabdi Express on the same route and speed. So, lightweight version is also, to be brought out. So Railway Ministry is looking at a lightweight version that could conserve power and hence plans to float global tender to procure the train sets and not from the ICF that indigenously built train 18 in record 18 months. So on some pretext or the other, they want to stop train 18 construction in India and want to buy trains from abroad. So that is being evident here, and even the railway officials are questioning this move of the government. Earlier, there were procedural flaws which were highlighted that the procedure was not correctly followed in the production, and that is why train 18 construction was stopped, production was stopped. And now the news comes that they say there is weight issue and production has been stopped and they want to buy from abroad. Then here, this is regarding review pleas in Ayodhya case. So four fresh review pleas have been filed. And here you have center objects Uttarakhand's definition of forest. So we had seen earlier how Uttarakhand has defined forest, deemed forest, and now central government has raised objections. It says order violates Supreme Court orders. So this is what the Ministry of External Affairs say. On editorial page, the first editorial is retributive justice. So this is regarding the front page news regarding the encounter of the four rape and murder accused. It says punishments must reinforce people's faith in the rule of law, not undermine it. So justice in any civilized society is not just about retribution. Retribution means revenge, but also about deterrence and in less serious crimes, rehabilitation of the offenders too. So the way the encounter has taken place, NHRC has also raised inquiry in that. The ideal way to go about it was quick justice through the judicial system, through law. So, and this is climate warnings. So this is regarding planned emission cuts, how they fall short of what needs to be done to contain global warming. So there have been studies which have shown that the pace at which climate change has been tackled, the Paris Agreement objectives would also not be achieved to reduce emissions, rise in temperature below 2 degrees Celsius, to less than 2 degrees Celsius. So this will also not be achieved. So more needs to be done to tackle climate change, reduce emissions. And the lead article is meals that can educate the young. So it says midday meal scheme, despite its transformative potential, is perceived as charity, not as a civic responsibility. So this article talks about midday meal scheme. And this is seeking truth and reconciliation in Chhattisgarh. So this is regarding the report by the body, the Sarke Guda report, as it is called, in which allegations of extrajudicial killings of alleged Naxalites is being spoken of. So it was not as a retaliation to attack, but they were killed at close range, as the report has highlighted. So there was also an editorial yesterday on this issue, yesterday or day before. So this is an article on that. That state government needs to institute a panel dealing with all extrajudicial killings. And this is ground zero coverage, which is there on every Saturday. So this is regarding Jammu and Kashmir. Internet blackout is going on in Jammu and Kashmir for more than 120 days. Startups which began with much fanfare are closing down now. And here you can see young Kashmiri entrepreneurs are leaving behind their homes and dreams to seek employment elsewhere. On page 12, you have Rajya Sabha discusses bill to scrap poll spend limit. So Rajya Sabha is discussing two private members' bills to do away with the cap on election spending by candidates and to establish a committee on foreign investment to prevent threats to national security. So there is a limit on spending by MPs, MLAs, by candidates fighting for the for an MP to serve as an MP or as an MLA. So these limits, spending limits, is here you can see 70 lakh per candidate. So they want to do away with this provision in the Representation of People's Act of 1951. On international page, you have China imposes reciprocal restrictions on US diplomats. So they have been told to notify the foreign ministry before meeting local officials. So the way USA imposes restrictions on Chinese diplomats, now China says we have taken reciprocal measures against US diplomats in China. Then you have Merkel makes a first visit to Auschwitz. So this is regarding Auschwitz in Poland, where a Nazi death camp was located. And Germany's Angela Merkel now crossed the gates of the former Auschwitz Nazi death camp, and in which the Jews, were killed under Nazi government of Hitler, who was from Germany. So Ms. Merkel is the only the third chancellor ever to visit the Nazi German camp where millions of Jews were killed between 1940 and 45, and which has come to symbolize the Holocaust as a whole. It is the 75th anniversary of the camp's liberation by Soviet troops in 2019, on January 27th in 2020. And here you have Iran protesters shot at from choppers rooftops. So this is the kind of force which Iranian government is using against protesters. It is said severe violence has been used during the unrest. This is what UN Human Rights Chief Michelle Bachelet says. Then on business page, you have Vodafone Idea may hang up, says Billa. So such a statement was earlier also given by Vodafone, that it is not viable to function in India because of the government not providing any relief on past statutory dues. So now again you can see such a statement has come. And this is audit for FDI firms must for e-commerce firms. So audit for FDI norms. So local traders have flagged big discounts, that how these e-commerce firms give big discounts. So because brick and mortar shops are affected because of these e-commerce firms. So audit for FDI norms will be a must. The government has issued new rules that make it compulsory for e-commerce companies with foreign investment to submit an audit report every year, showing that they have been in compliance with the FDI rules for the sector. And then you have Saudi Russia pushed through deeper oil cuts. So Saudi Arabia and Russia spearheaded a deal in which OPEC, Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, and its allies committed to some of the deepest oil output cuts this decade, aiming to avert oversupply and support prices. Then the last page has sports related news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashara.com. Thank you.